Hi, my name is Heather Francisco. I'm a Board Certified Behavior Analyst with Brett DiNovi & Associates, and welcome back to part two of parent training. In 2011, Fanouf and McIntyre created a three-tiered parent training model to assist families with young children who are diagnosed with developmental disabilities. The three-tiered model allows for continuous measurement over time of parent behavior after each tier. In previous research, the model has been proven effective to decrease negative parenting and increase positive parenting techniques. The improvements were also maintained after a three-month follow-up. Tier one includes parents being given reading material and/or audio tapes. The content will address the specifics of the interventions being proposed. The content will also inform parents how they can use praise, how they can limit setting events, how they might respond to target behavior, how they can provide constructive feedback and prompting, and how they can reinforce their child. Parents use a self-report to track their progress on reading the material, filling out assessments, and setting up a time with the BCBA for questions. Tier two consists of group training. Group training provides access to other parents and the BCBA in person. They can role play, use video modeling, and gain experience with multiple exemplars. After each training, parents are assigned homework to practice their skills in their natural environment. In between trainings, it is recommended that BCBAs conduct 1 to 2 individual observations to give immediate feedback on the implementation of skills. Tier three of the intervention consists of individualized video feedback training. Videos of parent behavior after all group trainings are taken and observed previous to the feedback session. The BCBA then pinpoints areas of strengths and weaknesses before the session. The BCBA will schedule a meeting in the home where they can address the feedback and use modeling, rehearsal, praise, and constructive feedback. There are pros and cons of using the three-tiered model. On the pro side, this model has proven to be effective in previous studies to maximize treatment outcomes, decrease time and costs of providing intensive individualized training, and can provide multiple exemplars and chances for diversified questions during group training. On the con side, there are less chances for direct and immediate feedback. This has only been studied with families with young children, and not all families will follow through or agree to video monitoring. Another tool for parent training includes behavioral skills training. According to Miles and Wilder in 2009, behavioral skills training is a package that teaches a person what to do when certain circumstances arise. The components include multiple opportunities for practice and feedback to increase fluency. The four steps include instructions, modeling, rehearsal, and feedback. When coming up with a training for parents, the instructions must be in terms that are understandable. They should include a rationale as to why the components are important. Each skill should be outlined so that the steps and expectations are clear. This also gives the parents a chance to read about when to use the skill, when to not use it, and when to repeat if necessary. After the parent has read the instructions, asked questions, and demonstrates an understanding of the material, the trainer or BCBA can now model what is expected. You can show the parent the phrases to use, how to manipulate materials, how to react to target behaviors, and how to take data, etc. You can also model what not to do or how to handle unique situations that may arise. In vivo modeling is recommended. Allow time for questions and answers throughout. Rehearsal gives the parents a chance to practice their skills and become more fluent. It is best to use in vivo rehearsal and role play. Both positive and constructive feedback should be clear and immediate. This also gives the BCBA a chance to reinforce the parents' hard work and effort they have been putting into training. Rehearsal is a great chance for the BCBA to take data on the implementation of the skill so that they can monitor progress and difficulties. Feedback can be used throughout behavioral skills training, as well as after training has concluded. Parsons and Reed in 1995 addressed steps for effective feedback. 1. Start with a positive or empathetic statement. 2. Provide positive feedback and praise. Explain at least one skill that was completed correctly. 3. Identify which category of the skill was completed incorrectly. And 4. Describe how that skill should be performed using modeling and role playing. 5. Solicit questions to ensure understanding. 6. Discuss what should happen next. And 7. End with a positive statement. Engaging the whole family in training helps to ensure effective behavior change. According to McMahon and Forehand in 2003, in order for the treatment to be carried out with a high rate of fidelity and at all times, it is important to include all family members that will be caretakers or interact with the child. BCBAs should ask the following questions when designing training. Does the whole family agree that the intervention is appropriate and potentially useful to help treat the problem at hand? Are they willing to become actively involved in the training? How has the BCBA incorporated trainings to include other family members? Did they complete the training? And what was their level of participation? BCBAs can also consider the guidelines for evaluating their parent training using the context, input, process, and product model of evaluation. According to Mathews and Hudson in 2001, the following is the model of evaluation. Context evaluation includes considering the appropriateness and acceptability of objectives. One might ask, are the objectives specific enough to the child, and do they fit ethically and culturally? Is the BCBA building on the parents' and child's strengths? Are the objectives technically adequate? Do they address who does what under what conditions? Input evaluation seeks to determine if the parent training is supported empirically and theoretically. Are the training models used acceptable based on the family's values? Process evaluation assesses if the training is being implemented with treatment integrity, how much did the parent participate and adhere to training procedures, and what is socially valid according to the parent. Product evaluation measures the outcome of training, such as parent knowledge of principles, ability to use the skills, and satisfaction with the strategies taught. To plan for generalization, a BCBA can ask how the child and parents change the behavior, and is it maintained over time? Consider strategies that lead to generalization when training parents, such as teaching loosely, using multiple exemplars, programming common stimuli, and using indiscriminable contingencies. Thank you for watching. Please feel free to post comments and questions below.